Okay, so why is the noise figure of an attenuator equals its loss? To understand this thing, let's first try to understand a little bit about the noise. So let's say if you have a resistor with value R, we know that it generates a thermal noise because of random motion of electrons. And we can model that noise with Vn equal square root 4KTBR. Okay. Now, the noise voltage that this resistor will produce at this end is proportional to the resistor value. But the noise power that this resistor will generate equals KTB. That means noise power is independent of the resistor value. So no matter what resistor you choose, it always end up generating the same power. So this is the maximum power that you can take from that resistor, provided that you terminate it with the matched load. You can easily find why is it the KTB. For example, let's say this is Vn, so voltage here is Vn by 2. So Vn by 2, so the power through this resistor is V square over R, which is 4KTBR divided by 4 divided by this resistor, and it comes out to be 4KTB because of this cancellation. Okay, so our resistor generates KTB noise. Okay, and at where K is the Boltzmann's constant, T is the temperature, and B is the bandwidth. So at room temperature of 290 Kelvin and the bandwidth of 1 Hertz, it gives us the noise power of minus 174 dBm per Hertz, which means this is the lowest noise floor that you can have per hertz bandwidth at room temperature. So if you analyze 1 hertz section, you will see it is minus 174 dBm. You can't go below than this. So this is the thermal noise, minimum noise that we have. Okay, so now we know that a resistor generates KTB noise. Okay, let's say we have an attenuator. Okay, and we design this attenuator so that it is matched both at the input and at the output. Let's say this is 10 dB attenuator, okay? Now, as I said, our resistor, 50 ohm, let's say resistor is 50 ohm, it generates KTB noise. Now, if we connect this resistor with this attenuator and look at here, now the argument here is the noise at this point is also KTB. That means the input noise and the output noise are same. Why is that? Because the impedance looking at this point, because this is matched, is 50 ohms. So essentially this all of this circuit, all of this thing can be reduced to just one impedance of 50 ohms with the source, and you will have KTB noise, provided that this attenuator is at the same temperature as this resistor. We can say that the noise at this port is equal. Okay, so the noise with and without the attenuator at this port is equal. So let's say this was the noise. Okay, now if we excite this port with a signal, let's say signal with the power x dBm, okay, and if we look at the signal here, so we would see the signal at this port was x dBm. Okay, this is this port, and at this port the signal will go down 10 dB attenuation, right? So here the signal would be x minus 10, right? So we see the signal amplitude decreased, but the noise did not change. It is same, right? It is KTB noise, right? That means there is 10 dB degradation in SNR. If there was some SNR here, now that SNR is 10 dB lower. So degradation in SNR is actually the noise figure, right? So 10 dB, we have 10 dB noise figure. That means the noise figure of an attenuator equals its loss. Okay? So this is one way of understanding it, which is not very correct, because it is counterintuitive, because we say that we provide signal here and that signal goes down 10 dB attenuation. Okay, this is attenuator, all right. But the noise, it does not go down any attenuation. The noise floor remains same. You give us some noise power here and you come up with the same power here. How can that be possible, right? Resistor has to attenuate that noise power. So actually it does attenuate that power, but then it end up generating enough power that you have the same noise power here and here. Because this can change, right? Because we said that a resistor will generate KTB noise independent of its value, right? So looking here and here, we've seen the same, we see just a resistor, right? So it has to generate KTB noise. So then, if you have made your peace with the fact that the noise here and here are both KTB, we can derive it mathematically and see how much noise does it attenuate and how much noise does this attenuator generate. Okay, so for that, let me choose this black color. Okay, so let's make it more general. Let's say we have attenuator with the loss L. Okay, and we're interested in noise at this board. So the noise here should be noise generated by this resistor, which is KTB, multiplied by the gain of this resistor or this attenuator, which is actually the loss. So I would denote it by L, plus the noise added by this attenuator, which is NA. Okay. Again, we said that noise here and here is equal. So that means this noise should be equal to this noise, which was KTB, right? KTB. So you can now say the noise added by this attenuator is L minus 1 KTB. Now we know that we can model any system with this equivalent temperature, and that is given by the noise power that system generates divided by K and B, right? Similarly, we can do that here. We can bring that KB down here. We have L minus 1 T here, so we can replace this. So this is the equivalent noise temperature of the attenuator, and we know that the noise factor is given by 1 plus TE by T naught. Putting that TE here, we get 1 plus L minus 1 TE. This would be T. This is TE, this would be T, yeah, because this comes here. T by T naught. So at room temperature, we have T equal T naught. So this and this cancels, minus 1 plus 1 cancels, and we are left with L. So at room temperature, the noise figure of an attenuator equals its loss, right? And this is what we said when we began this argument, that the noise at this and this port are only same if the attenuator is at the same temperature as this resistor, right? So now there are two ways of seeing it. The one which is easier, you can just say attenuator doesn't produce any noise, it just reduces your signal by the attenuation by that amount, and your signal becomes more closer to the noise floor, hence the noise figure increases and it is the same as much as attenuation you have. This is one way of seeing it, which is not the way I would like to see it. The other way of seeing it that okay, the resistor, the attenuator, whatever it is composed of, resistors, capacitors, it does reduce your noise floor as well, but then it generates enough amount of noise that you end up getting the similar noise here. So essentially this is what happens. The noise floor remains same, signal degraded by 10 dB, that's why the noise floor is equal to its loss. Okay, all right.